All right, here's a photo that we're going to paint today. And it's a real nice kind of dusky night scene with this real strong, powerful light over here. I don't know, the auto exposure is not showing you the fullness of it, but it is this soft blur back here. And you can see these utility poles kind of start and drop out and pick up again. And even in this utility pole, there's a real darkness up here, but as the glow from the light and the halo effect gets in here, we get a little bit of lightness there. You can also see on this far building here, on that first little part of the building is lighter than this part here. And so I've taken it into Photoshop where I can analyze the values. And what I've seen here is this whole picture is made up mostly of pretty pure primaries. We've got some all these oranges up here seem to be based in a cad red type color. There's a little bit of yellow in here, probably a medium yellow. Everything else is some form of mixture of cobalt blue. And so we're going to use those three colors primarily, and probably only those three colors. And then we'll probably end up coming back in at the end to pick out some of these highlights with some gouache, with some tinted gouache. But there's our photo. This is a photo I found one of the guys I follow on Flickr. And I really like this photo. There's actually what appears to be maybe a baseball field over here. And that would make sense with all these lights. But I like this because I'm kind of into spy novels. And this has that feeling of a dusky evening with somebody walking down the road, kind of checking out who's in there. So, yeah, I may add a figure, a dark figure, maybe somewhere over here. That's to be seen. It depends on how well this comes off. I'm going to try a real wet and wet technique for the sky. And we're going to protect this area right here by not wetting this area. We're gonna wet this area, we're gonna wet this road here and put in our basic colors there. And we're gonna go from there. Let's see how it works. Okay, for this painting, I went in with just a number 4 pencil and drew in the basic outlines. And you don't have to be real detailed here. And then we went in with just water and wet the paper. Now I did protect the area of the buildings with the water, but brought it on down into the street area. We want these colors to merge together. Then I went in to build this gradated light, and began with a little yellow, and I grade everything down by adding its complement, and just work that sky up into a nice kind of reddish gray. Pulled out some of the colors there where the lights were, and picking out that little window there for later. But I wanted to put some real deep dark values into these buildings here and into this street. And so again, this is just a 3-color painting, cad red, cad yellow medium, and cobalt blue. And I found that you could pretty much get any color you needed out of those, for this painting at least. And that helps to unify the palette, unify the painting. You don't have some odd color popping up just at random. So putting in the basic colors here, and even going in with some darks. And this is kind of not the way you're supposed to do watercolor, by getting your darkest darks in there first, but I'm going to have to darken those even more. And so I'm going in with darks where I need them. The sky really worked out well, except in the end, after it was finished, I kind of thought, in retrospect, it looks kind of like there's a volcano or a blazing fire back there rather than a baseball field. Here we're putting in some shadows. Everything in the yards of these little houses is surrounded by chain link fence, and there's a bunch of trash cans out front. And so I just kind of put that chain link fence in there, representing it as just a value shape. Here we go in, starting to pick out some details, starting to go in with what I'd call the second round, putting in your middle values and some detail, picking out some detail. Now, I'm not real careful with detail. I just like to suggest things. If I was to get all hung up in detail, it'd take forever to do a 1-hour painting. And that's not the kind of painting I like to do. I like to just kind of suggest the windows, suggest the shadows. And overall, I think it worked out. So here I am darkening these buildings a bit. They're a little too bright. This is kind of a dusky, almost night scene. And the buildings, I had to go in and darken them several times, just like that. And it worked out. So, yeah, let's see here. I really needed some darks in this bottom area here This area is in shadow, the shadow cast by the buildings, but also the street has a lot of imperfections in it. And I just wanted to kind of catch the coolness of the street against the dark, the warmness of the sky. And I think it came across okay. There is some grass over there, a little bit of a lawn, but it doesn't show up very well. I just put some warm colors in there to represent that little wedge of a lawn. And here we go, picking out a little more details. In this yard, there's a lot of junk in there. And you just represent junk with painting noise, just junk. And that's just kind of a common technique. You just suggest stuff back there. Who knows what it is, you know, play stuff, trash cans. It doesn't matter. You just put some junk in there. And so that's what I'm doing, suggesting clutter. Here's the utility pole, the first one, and there's the second one. And I am using the little technique that you can see when you're out in the wild there, and lifting out some colors there where the light shines, because that's an optical effect and it gives the impression of light. It's sort of that halo effect of light behind a dark object. It gets lighter where the light is behind it, at least to our eye, we perceive it that way. Here's the all the utility wires, and there's a lot of stuff, a lot of utility stuff on these buildings. These buildings aren't built for beauty. And here I go, putting in some more street detail. And yeah, those wires there, that's the kind of what makes the whole painting. And there's wires going over to the buildings, and there's lots of wires trailing down the buildings. I added these trees here. I thought it needed it. I thought the flat faces of the buildings were too much, and I thought we'll put some trees in there. Going in with some white gouache. This is non-canonical, but that's what I do. And put some highlights here and there, picked out some details. The little reflections on all the trash cans was really necessary. That's just something that you could either scratch out, but I like to use the gouache. I did go in and use the gouache to suggest highlights on the chain link fence. I think that's a little much. I probably shouldn't have done that, but there you can see it in the final painting that the chain link fence is just suggested. But overall it worked, I think, other than the fact that it looks like there's a volcano back there. Well, there you go. Thanks for joining me. I appreciate it. Please subscribe to the channel, and we'll talk to you next time. Bye-bye.